Good morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome to Shri Hansraj Aheer ji, Shri Munish Gupta ji, Shri Anand Bhaskar Rupuli ji, Shri Tarunangya ji, Dr. Tushti Bharadwaj ji, and my dear student. My name is Roli Shukla, and I am a member of Next Gen Political Leaders. First of all, I wish you a very happy Constitution Day. Let's begin our celebration with Vande Mataram song sung by Alcon Group of School Students.
Chief guest, Sri Hansraj Aheer ji, former Central Minister, MoS, Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. Our guest of honor, Sri Munish Gupta, President, Foreign Correspondent Club of South Asia. Our special speakers of the panel, Sri Anand Bhaskar Rupulu, former Member of Parliament, Sri Tarun Nangya, a content conceptualizer, and Dr. Tushti Bharadwaj, Associate Professor, Delhi University, media persons, teachers, and students. Sansad Ratna Awards Committee, Next Gen Political Leaders and Prime Point Foundation has been fortunate enough to celebrate the Constitution Day since 2018 and will continue to do so. Sansad Ratna Awards is an initiative to felicitate best performing parliamentarians on the basis of their performance in the Parliament, which was inaugurated by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam himself. We are bestowing these awards for the past 12 years, and about 75 MPs till now have been given this award. Next Gen Political Leaders is an apolitical initiative to create awareness about our political system, public policy, civic responsibility, and so on by current and past politicians, serving and retired bureaucrats, retired judges, and eminent lawyers, professors, and subject matter experts, which was the vision of Dr. Kalam. Both our initiatives are politically neutral and from the civil society front. This year, we are celebrating it as a national conclave for 4 years, 4 days, starting 25th to 28th November, both physical and virtual event, on the title Role of Civil Society and Indian Democracy. We have chosen the topic, each one day of each different topics, day one being Nation Before Self, day two being Importance of Fundamental Duties and Directive Principles of State Policy, day three being the role of teachers in creating awareness about fundamental duties, and day four being the role of civil society for a better system with case studies. So we are celebrating our constitution, meaning a legal document. But why should we? For not merely because it's one of the lengthiest handwritten document, not because of its unique salient features, not because it's the most comprehensive yet exhaustive piece, but for its remarkable vision for future as a guiding prerogative during a crisis, a reference document of righteousness, and a document of my welfare, your welfare, and each and everybody's welfare across India. We own a constitution that is unique, exclusive, and has contrasting features yet with a balance, complementing checks, and still proves to be the supreme. We are so glad that from 2015 onwards, the National Law Day is celebrated at Constitution Day, which stands appropriate and self-explanatory. Just imagine our forefathers started this research of structuring this document almost 150 years ago. And even today, at the juncture of crisis, be it political, economical, social, or anything below the skies, our reference document is our constitution, because it's the supreme. Now, think to yourself, do we really need a reason to celebrate, embrace, recognize this exceptional document just once a year, or read, respect, resonate its magnanimity every single day? And remember, there are a few parts of the constitution that our responsibility to read, understand, and follow, because they are the foundation to make you a modern citizen with ethical etiquettes. A moral and a value-based person who lives up to the principles, not merely it's obligatory, but it's fundamental. Such fundamental parts of Constitution is Part 4 and Part 4A, which deals with directive principles of state policy and fundamental duties. We all always talk about our rights, fight for it, and demand it. But we don't even know what our 11 fundamental duties are. And most of us feel it's very irrelevant, and that's the unfortunate part. It can't be the way any longer. Understanding fundamental duties is equally or even more important than understanding fundamental rights. Duties bring sense of responsibility and accountability. The directive principles, though can't be enforced by the orientation of good governance, a reference that needs to be applied while making law, a directive to attain a welfare state. Be it right to education, be it eradication of child labor, be it free legal aid, be it maternity benefit, or be it equal pay for equal work, they all are from this visionary part of Constitution, which is the directive principles of state policy. That is why the legend, the chief architect of our Constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, quoted, "Constitution is not a mere lawyer document. It is a vehicle of life, and its spirit is always of age." Yes, the spirit of Constitution is always the age, and there is a reason why we reached out to schools this year to celebrate the Constitution Day. Till about a couple of years, we chose young adults and reached to them. We felt the need to go deeper. Last 2 years, we targeted university students. We still felt the need to go deeper. We realized the school adolescent students are those who are actually making the change. They are the most optimistic, most spirited, and most strongest. Yes, they hold the strongest willpower and highest aspiration to progress. If parents and teachers show the right, required dedication to shape the lives of young children, India will get a new life. The quote given by our guru, whose blessing from above, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. A quick insight is that today, India has 40% of population which is 0 to 20 years. So reaching, connecting, motivating, creating opportunities to these minds is our responsibility. We, Prime Point Foundation, Next Gen Political Leaders, Sansad Ratna Awards Committee, are doing our bit to tell the youngsters that we are with you in every progressive step you take. So with young minds, with constructive dreams, and who are going to act passionately, please count on us to be next to you. In this front, I take this opportunity to officially announce Next Gen Political Leaders is going to open its students' wing that will cater exclusively for students from the standard of 9th and above and university students. This student wing is an attempt to cater the need to create awareness and clarity regarding our political system and our civic responsibility. This will create future leaders and policymakers. I take immense pleasure in announcing Alcon Group of Schools to be our forerunner in Delhi NCR and lead NGPL Students Wing. With high respect and admiration to Dr. Ashok Pandey, I am sure we will succeed in creating awareness, understanding about the system we live in. And with all my folded hands and heart, I welcome each one of you to be present here for this August gathering. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Advocate Priyadarshini Rawat. That was great, and we all are very proud of the holy document, our constitution. Now, may I request Mr. Sanjay Yadav, Principal, Alcon International School, to deliver introductory speech.
Yes, Prasad ji, Munish ji, Ms. Priyadarshini, and of course I must recall Srinivasan sir, though he has not been able to join us today. I'm sure our children, they did listen to sir yesterday, and all the dignitaries and panelists for today who are here to share their wonderful thoughts, my dear teachers. And as you've heard two terms right now, one of them which talks about next generation leaders. So this is how I address my children, that they are the next generation leaders. And today if we are celebrating this day, aur usme aap sab hamare saath jud paaye hain, there is nothing better than that, because as school and as educators, we feel that it is our prime duty. When we are talking about rights and duties, so I take it as our prime duty to connect our children with our soul, that is our country. And the best way to connect is to make each one of them give that expression, because I think today there could be nothing better to begin the day with reading the preamble, with the permission of everyone. And I am going to read it in Hindi, because there are certain things which I will read in English and Hindi both. आप सबने प्रीएम्बल पढ़ा है, सभी किताबों में आपके लिखा होता है. एक बार दोबारा आज इस महत्वपूर्ण दिन पर आइए हम इसको अपने साथ जुड़ते हैं और समझते हैं. हम भारत के लोग, भारत को एक संपूर्ण प्रभुत्व संपन्न समाजवादी पक्ष पंथ निरपेक्ष लोकतंत्रात्मक गणराज्य बनाने के लिए तथा उसके समस्त नागरिकों को, अब जो मैं पॉइंट्स पढ़ने जा रहा हूं उनको समझने की जरूरत है और उनको महसूस करने की जरूरत है, सामाजिक आर्थिक और राजनैतिक न्याय. दिस इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट. सेकंड, विचार अभिव्यक्ति विश्वास धर्म और उपासना की स्वतंत्रता. कीवर्ड्स यहां पर न्याय स्वतंत्रता. उसके बाद प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर की समता प्राप्त कराने के लिए, समता इज अनदर कीवर्ड हियर, तथा उन सब में व्यक्ति की गरिमा और राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता को सुनिश्चित कराने वाली बंधुता को बढ़ाने के लिए दृढ़ संकल्प होकर अपनी इस संविधान सभा में आज तारीख 26 नवंबर 1949 को एतत द्वारा इस संविधान को अंगीकृत अधिनियमित और आत्मसमर्पित करते हैं. सो दिस इज समथिंग विच इज अवर गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल एंड द फोर वर्ड्स. बिफोर आई कोट दीज फोर वर्ड्स, ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव ऑल रिकॉल्ड लेजेंडरी बी आर अम्बेडकर जी हु वाज प्रिसाइडिंग. सो हिज स्पीच विच ही हैड गिवन इट, देयर इज अ कोट विच आई एम टेकिंग फ्रॉम देयर, which was on 25th November 1949 at the Constituent Assembly. It was the last speech which was delivered. And there the thought which was expressed, what Indians must do. If you wish to maintain democracy, not in the form, but also in fact, then do not be content with mere political democracy, but strive for social democracy. And this is the soul of our Constituent. Of course, we are living in the age of social revolution. और आज हम जिस तरह से एक दूसरे से जुड़ पा रहे हैं, जिस तरह से एक दूसरे के पास पहुंच सकते हैं, अपने विचारों को व्यक्त कर सकते हैं, आप सभी बच्चे इतने भाग्यशाली हैं कि आप एक स्वतंत्र राज्य में, देश में आपका जन्म हुआ. और केवल जन्म ही नहीं हुआ, आपको जिस तरह से अपब्रिंगिंग मिल रही है, जितनी फ्रीडम आपको मिली है, ताकि उसका एक इफेक्ट ये होता है कि हर बच्चा कॉन्फिडेंटली ये कहता है कि मैं डिसाइड कर सकता हूँ मुझे क्या करना है. और यही हम स्कूल्स में आपको अवसर प्रदान कर रहे हैं. अवसर प्रदान करने के अलावा हम आपको एक मार्गदर्शन दे रहे हैं. व्हाट इज अवर एफर्ट इज टू गिव यू द डायरेक्शन एंड थॉट प्रोसेस. वी आर नॉट टेकिंग यू, बट वी आर ओनली मेंटरिंग यू, वी आर ओनली गाइडिंग यू. वी वॉन्ट यू टू डिसाइड योर ओन पाथ, एंड दैट इज व्हाई द फ्यूचर ऑफ इंडिया lies in your hands, and you are the ones who are going to make a difference. So try and understand that what a big responsibility lies on your shoulder. Aaj agar aapko jitni bhi aapko adhikar diye ja rahe hain uske saath koi aapse nahi mangega ki aapke kartavya kya hain aur aapko kya karna chahiye is rashtra ke liye. क्योंकि केवल अगर इसको एक डॉक्यूमेंट में बोलना या आपसे कहा जाए कि ये आपको करना है, उससे दिल से ये भावना नहीं आती है। उससे बेहतर ये है कि हम आपको ये चीज़ महसूस करवा सकें। वी मेक यू फील, वी मेक यू लिव थ्रू दैट एंड लेट इट कम इंटरनल। सो दिस इज व्हाट हैज़ बीन आवर एफर्ट। और आज इसी श्रृंखला में एल्कॉन ग्रुप ऑफ स्कूल्स अपने आप को बहुत भाग्यशाली मांगते हैं कि प्राइम पॉइंट फाउंडेशन ने हमारे साथ हाथ जोड़ा है इस बारे में, और हम मिल करके यही भावना अपने बच्चों में, और ना केवल अपने बच्चों में बाकी सभी में, हम इस भावना को आगे ले जाना चाहते हैं। और मुझे विश्वास है कि कल जिस तरह से मैंने 20 बच्चों के विचार सुने, आप भी थे उसमें, जितनी एनर्जी के साथ और जितने कनेक्ट के साथ, सेल्फ कन्विक्शन के साथ बच्चों ने बातें की हैं, इनफैक्ट एट टाइम्स लिसनिंग टू दीज यंगस्टर्स इट गिव्स अस डायरेक्शन। सुनकर के हमें पता चलता है कि किस तरह से हमें अपने इस देश को आगे ले जाने के लिए योगदान देना चाहिए। तो ये बहुत अच्छी पहल है, और आगे दो दिन भी मैं चाहूँगा कि आप लोग हमारे इस आयोजन में, इस समारोह में, इस राष्ट्रीय पर्व में हमारे साथ जुड़े रहें। और एज इट वॉज वेरी राइटली सेड दैट इट्स नॉट जस्ट द डे, केवल एक दिन का हमारा ये सेलिब्रेशन नहीं है, रादर इन एवरी डे, जस्ट एज यू प्रे फॉर योर सेल्फ, यू प्रे फॉर योर फैमिली, यू प्रे फॉर ऑल द पीपल अराउंड यू, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर योर नेशन, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर। और एक जो बहुत अच्छी बात इसमें कही गई है प्रीएम्बल में कि सेल्फ को भी रखा गया है, आप अपना भी विकास उसके बारे में भी आप सोचिए, क्योंकि जब आपका अपना विकास होगा तभी आपके राष्ट्र का विकास होगा। तो उसके लिए मेहनत कीजिए। आज आपका एक ये कर्तव्य अपने लिए, खुद के लिए बनता है कि अच्छे से पढ़ें, अपने आप को नॉलेजेबल इंसान बनाएं, जो भी आपकी एक्सपर्टीज है उसको आप फर्दर डेवलप करें, तो आप उस राष्ट्र निर्माण में एक बहुत अच्छा सहयोग दे पाएंगे। वी आर सो डिलाइटेड दैट दिस सेलिब्रेशन इज कंटिन्यूइंग, एंड आज हमें बहुत अच्छे एक्सपर्ट्स और लोगों से उनके विचार सुनने को मिलेंगे, जिससे हमें और मार्गदर्शन मिलेगा, एंड आई एम श्योर वी विल बी एबल टू वर्क टुगेदर एंड टेक दिस नेशन फॉरवर्ड। सो विद दिस आई वेलकम एवरीवन एंड टेक प्लेजर इन सेइंग दैट यस, we are privileged to have this opportunity, and let us continue putting in our effort. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. You were also very motivational and inspirational for us. Thank you. May I request? Moving forward, may I request Team Sansad Ratna and Team Next Gen Political Leaders to present the mementos. May I request Dr. Ashok Pandey sir, Director Elcon Group of Schools, to deliver memento to Shri Hansraj Ahir ji. Thank you, sir. May I request Shri Sanjay Yadav ji to deliver memento to Shri Munish Gupta ji. Advocate Narasimha Murthy, Team Next Gen Political Leader, to deliver memento to Shri Anand Bhaskar Rupulu ji. May I request Shri T.N. Ashok, former PTI editor, to give memento, to deliver memento to Shri Tarun Nandia ji. May I request Shri Jay Krishna, Team Next Gen Political Leader, to deliver memento to Dr. Tushti Bharadwaj. May I request Advocate Priyadarshini Rahul, President Sansad Ratna Awards Committee and founding president of Next Gen Political Leader, to deliver my mentor to Elkhorn School. Video message from Sri Primeprawn Srinivasan Ji, founder chairman Sansad Ratna Awards Committee and chairman Next Gen Political Leaders, to give this to August audience. May I request
on 26th November 1949. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Happy Constitution Day. On 26th November 1949, Indian Constitution was adopted by the Constituent Assembly. The Constitution was drafted by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. It was effective from 26th January 1950. Though we are celebrating the Indian Republic Day on 26th January every year, we used to celebrate 26th November as a national law day. In 2015, our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi wanted this Constitution Day, 26th November, has to be celebrated as a Constitution Day by all the people. That's why we have been celebrating the Constitution Day for the past 4 years. On behalf of our Prime Point Foundation, Sansad Ratna Awards Committee, Next Gen Political Leaders, and the Digital Journalists Association of India, I convey my greetings to all of you on this happy occasion. Our youngsters in this country, the age group of 0 to 20, constitute around 40%. They are the very vulnerable area. Within another 20 years, they will be taking over the administration. They will be taking over the entire governance of this country. We need to have a preparation. We need to prepare them as a good leaders and good citizens. They should be given good awareness about the Indian values, ethics, and about the Constitution. That's why this year we chose to go to the school and create an awareness about the Constitution and its values to all the school children and teachers. Dr. Ashok Pandeji has been kind enough to provide all the support in his group of schools, and yesterday we had a very good inter-school competition participated by 10 school children. And I'm very happy that eminent parliamentarians like Hansraj Ahirji and Mr. Rapolo, they have all joined today, and they are going to greet all of us here. Minister Manish Guptaji, the president of Foreign Correspondents Club of South Asia, has been kind enough to provide all the support to us. I wish you a very happy Constitution Day, and I'll meet you again. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram, Bharat Mata Ki Jai.